Doom isn't 3D. It is likely you heard that phrase before. And if you are a classic Doom enthusiast, you probably disagree. Yet the amount of this in Doom is debatable. What's the deal? Well, the engine has specific limitations which support the not 3D argument. In this video, we'll go through all of them. Let's get started. No rooms above rooms. This limitation is infamous, but it's only a part of a bigger picture. To see it better, let's take a look at how Doom maps are built. Every level consists of so-called sectors. Each sector has a 2D shape as its foundation, and two numbers, how high is the floor and how high is the ceiling. That really is all the information we have, but it's enough to make all sorts of structures, like the staircase followed by a hallway. Floor and ceiling levels can also be dynamic, so you can have things like doors, which are basically moving ceilings, or elevators, which are moving floors. This design is very simple and complex at the same time. Complex enough to make some stunning environments if you know what you're doing. These sector-based levels are easy enough to process for computers from 90s, but you have to accept certain limitations. All sectors must have completely flat and leveled floors. Every wall must be straight and perfectly vertical. And finally, level geometry doesn't exist under the floor or above the ceiling. That's impossible with this simple sector model. Despite all those constraints, maps can look very impressive and showcase all three dimensions really well. But they will always be blocky and have these chunky straight edges. Furthermore, many old maps seem to be very flat. So flat that you might think that Doom doesn't have a z-axis. Of course, this is not true. Every room in every level is 3D. Positions and boundaries of objects in game are three-dimensional. And there are plenty of examples when the z-axis matters. Shall we? Monsters may not fit into rooms because of their height. Some enemies can fly and change their altitude. Also, they will fit into windows when at appropriate vertical position. Projectiles can fly as well, and not necessarily parallel to the ground. Players can close gaps between separated platforms, but not if the platform is too high to reach. You can even jump with the help of an archwile blast, clearing obstacles you otherwise couldn't. By now it should be quite clear, there is enough Z in Doom. But why is it still debatable? Well, there are a few notable examples where poor Z is simply ignored by game. First, the case of infinitely tall monsters. Frankly, this is one of the most jarring limitations. In Manila Doom, you cannot move directly above or below monsters. It's like there is an invisible barrier. Look, even tiny lost soul struggles to reach you through this seemingly open space. This is done to simplify collision physics and make the game compute faster. The engine doesn't have to deal with stacks of objects. Modern source ports can handle it without much trouble, but vanilla version is stuck with this limitation. Interestingly, projectiles can pass above and below any objects. It's likely because of a well-known fact, projectiles don't have legs. They can't run around and make sick platforming. No, they're quite primitive, just follow a straight path until some obstacle is met. And not even necessarily straight, guided revenant missiles get a pass as well. Okay, back to limitations. Another instance of z-axis not mattering, explosions. Blast damage is applied based on the distance between ground zero and victims, but z-coordinate is not taken into account. So the blast wave appears to be infinitely tall. Again, this simplification was made deliberately. In most combat scenarios, vertical positions of explosions don't matter. Optimization intent is quite obvious. You see, having vertical distance is very easy to program, requires few extra lines of code, and the only reason not to do it would be to give those weak CPUs some extra breathing space. We have covered quite a few examples now. There is one last thing, which seems like a lack of z-axis, but actually isn't. Fixed camera angle. Not being able to look up and down is the first thing you notice, going from modern shooters back to the good old Doom. Why is that? Does the Doom guy have severe neck pains? To understand the reason, we have to know how the rendering works in vanilla Doom. The most important aspect here is that the walls are rendered as columns, basically vertical lines of pixels. To better explain it, let's modify this texture and put in two bright pixels directly on top of each other. Here is this texture in game. Notice how no matter from what angle you're looking, they're always directly on top of each other, just like in the source picture. When the game needs to render this part of wall, it takes one pixel wide slice of texture, scales it appropriately and puts it on the screen. That works well, but as soon as we turn the camera up, outer pixels begin to shift away because of the perspective. You no longer can use this column technique. Look at these pillars, they're drawn perfectly straight up. And when you look up, they converge in the distance, as they should. Of course, I'm showing all this in a more advanced rendering engine. You can rotate the camera freely, and the scene looks just fine. But let's jump into Crispy Doom. It uses the old column-based method in order to look more authentic. It also has a vertical aim, and it seems fine at first. But look closer, Aote's pixels don't shift away anymore. In fact, there is no perspective at all, and the whole picture is just scrolled up and down. These pillars now stay vertical at all costs. Crispy Doom even limits the angle of vertical aim, but we are not afraid to crank it up, are we? Oh no, what have I done? The scene becomes ridiculously distorted. Yeah, let's not do that ever again. So there you go, old rendering method was heavily optimized for one and only one vertical angle. It has nothing to do with game physics, and the z-axis still exists. Auto-aim is simply an assistant feature. Without it, you would be defenseless against foes from above and below. Modern graphics technology like OpenGL takes the same level geometry, the same textures, and allows you to appreciate Doom from every angle. It's not that easy to simply state Doom is or isn't three-dimensional. There are good reasons to believe one way or another. But if you ask me, the answer is in the title. Doom Engine is limited, but still 3D. The goal of this video was to visualize and explain Doom Engine's many shortcomings. Hopefully you learned something new, and even if not, at least found it entertaining. One last thing, I'd like to recommend a great article by Fabien Sanglard. It explains Doom Engine in greater details, especially how the rendering works. It became a source of some points made in this video, so give it a read if you want to know more. Thanks for watching, and see you around!